Good morning, CNS. Today is Friday, April 30th, 2021, and it is an A day. I am Jake Seitz.
And I'm Tori Rockwood. Good morning, everyone.
There is only one announcement for today. The senior ball is happening June 11th at the Marriott Hotel downtown.
Oh my God.
Tickets are on sale from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. in the main entrance and during all three lunches from now until May 4th.
May the 4th be with you.
The cost is $45 per person.
$45.
Check the senior ball letter for time slots and room options.
Now, here's Owens with sports.
All right, the Lady North Stars lacrosse team traveled to FM last night and took down the Hornets 18-12. The North Stars led by Fran Tortora with 5 goals and Brooke Molchanoff with 4. They look to continue tomorrow as they play Liverpool in their home opener at Michael J. Bragman Stadium, opening faceoff at noon. The boys lacrosse team had their season opener last night hosting FM. The JV squad took a devastating loss 19-2 before the varsity team took the field. The game was close all the way up to the final whistle, but the North Stars came up short 16-10. The boys will travel to Liverpool this Saturday and next Monday to face the Warriors on their home turf. Good luck, boys. April showers bring athletic cancellations. Girls golf and girls softball both had their contests canceled due to poor weather. Boys baseball is optimistic that their game will happen this evening. Good luck, everybody. Round 1 of the NFL draft was held yesterday. However, the top NFL story quickly became that Aaron Rodgers is very unhappy with the Packers and looks like his season with them is in jeopardy. We have a full draft recap next week. That's all for sports. Back over to you guys.
Thank you, Owen. And speaking of the draft, we are going to turn things over to the MediaCom guys who will be talking more about the NFL draft from last night.
So I think the best way to open this up is a formal apology to Aaron Rodgers and the fans of the Green Bay Packers organization. As a diehard Packer fan myself, we have failed to draft and make our quarterback happy again. So I think that's where we need to open this.
He's going to the Vikings. Goodbye, Aaron Rodgers.
And with that, welcome to our post-draft recap. Tensions are running high here in the studio with my colleagues, Robbie Bobby and Nikki D. We have a great draft for us. I want to start off by asking, what do you think about the first three picks, all quarterbacks coming from the first three picks of this draft? Trevor Lawrence, very necessary for the Jacksonville Jaguars team. What do you think about Trey Lance and Zach Wilson, the second and third?
You know, Dalton, I think these picks are justified. They're very smart. Each of these teams needed a quarterback. Jimmy G, I kind of want to see him start the season for the 49ers, but as of right now, I can understand why all three quarterbacks were taken, and I do feel bad for Gardner Minshew, but I can understand the pick.
I feel like Zach Wilson overall, out of the three, is after Trevor Lawrence, he is the second best. He's definitely better than Lance. I feel like Garoppolo is going to have a hard time trying to get it, like, as the starting position, because he's going to have that pressure coming on. So we'll see where he ends up.
All right, now my next question is, we have a lot of picks, 32 picks in this first round. What is your favorite pick in the first round of this draft?
You know, as my last name being Bateman, Baltimore's 27th pick, Rashud Bateman, pretty cool. If he went to the Packers, I'd probably get his jersey, but that's it. And then, honestly, the pick I'm most questionable about is number 10, Devontae Smith. I don't know how he'll adapt to the league being undersized, but he was the Heisman winner last year, so we'll see how he works out.
I will say I also am very questionable about that pick. I just feel like the Eagles end up taking a wide receiver every single year. But my favorite pick, and I've stuck by this since even before the draft, I love Kyle Pitts at number 4. Going to the Falcons, you got Matt Ryan. You have arguably one of the best wide receiver corps in Julio Jones and Calvin Ridley. I think that's going to be a very scary offense this year.
And my final question for today, what do you think is the worst pick, your least favorite, something that you think was a complete idiocracy?
Nick, I'm going to take the show here.
I think we can agree on the same thing here.
Number 5, Ja'Marr Chase for the Bengals. They don't need another wide receiver, so what are they doing?
We did not agree on the same thing.
And then we move over to Travis Etienne. Okay. He's not a great running back. He's all right. He's Trevor Lawrence's running back from Clemson, but the Jaguars already have a running back. You don't need him. So, bit of a waste of a pick. And the pick that I understand, but I can't get my head around is Green Bay taking a cornerback.
Shut up with the Green Bay.
Dude, Eric Stokes, man. Why?
It doesn't matter.
Unless if he gains 50 pounds and plays D-end, he's going to do nothing for
us.
You
had 5 years of opportunities. You blew every single one of them.
It's been 16 years since Green Bay has taken a skilled player in the first round, and time after time again, we have failed to make the best player in the league happy, and it's been a struggle.
Just give it up. In my mind, it's 25 is the worst one. You have James Robinson. You have a guy that's going to be there for years. Why do you need another one? That's just my pick. But seriously, Green Bay's run is over.
And that's going to be it for our draft recap. Thank you guys so much for tuning in, and good luck to all these players and their future teams.
For lunches today, there will be bacon cheeseburgers, okay, French fries, and assorted fruits.
It's like a budget Tully's.
Mmm,
And that's all for today from the CNS Morning Show. I am Jake Seitz.
And I'm Tori Rockwood. Have a great weekend.